Well, I found out what the damage was. It wasn't the ramp that got damaged, it was the edge here. Probably, you know, bounding boxes touched and wrecked. Well, not really wrecked, but bent this section. I just, since I'm already recording, I just added another battery, which is charging right now. And I also added the moisture vaporator for when I'm in an atmosphere. And then I added a productivity module, which bumps it up to 150% productivity. So we'll see how that works out when we're in another environment with an atmosphere. It should at least slowly fill up my ice reserves, so I don't have to mine for every little kilogram of ice that I need for hydrogen. Since this thing runs solely on hydrogen, that's important. Now, what I'm thinking about doing here, I was brainstorming a bit going, you know, I can't really expand this out this way because of the bay doors. Now, I technically can and probably will just rip those doors out, bring this side out even further so that I can park bigger ships in there. But I was also thinking, what if I want to store a ship inside that was taller than two blocks? Well, I can use these. If I had a tall enough ship, I can put these on the top and on the bottom, so it would allow me to fly a ship four blocks high through it. And I'm going, you know, that sounds really cool to have, like, you know, big double doors that would allow me to do that. And then I was like, okay, on top of that, I do have some stuff out here that's a little squishy, meaning that susceptible to easily be damaged by pirates. Now, this was kind of expensive to make, this radar, so I would really like to put that somewhere safer. I wouldn't mind moving the antenna either, but the antenna is really big. It's kind of hard to conceal that. And I'm going, you know, I can't really expand upward because I have the windows here. I have this nice landing pad, which I do really like to be able to pull my ships up here. And it's an even run to the welders, so I can actually pull the ship right off here, right over the welders, and fix it up. I already have my turrets built, you know, one block higher so that they won't shoot anything that's parked down here. And, you know, doing anything with this platform over here would be kind of tough because I do need a place to park the truck, and this is the perfect size for it. I can't expand, I mean, I can expand out the back here if I wanted to, like, to make this area back here longer. I can't really do anything at all on this side because of the solar panels. They're very finicky on touching other blocks, so expanding this way is not really an option. So I'm going, what can I do? Look at all this stuff underneath here that if I was in space could easily be damaged or destroyed by, you know, a single rocket coming from one of those bad guys. If one hit anything under here, it would be a hell to fix. I got my batteries down here. I have my programming blocks, my timers, all this stuff that I would want to replace, all my gyros. So I'm thinking, what the hell? Maybe I'll raise this thing off the ground, maybe a couple more blocks, and have like a second floor, like an engineering floor underneath the main floor, where I could keep all my squishy stuff, and then I could set up, since there's already conveyor systems down here. I have conveyor running all the way from front to back. I could easily, that will easily allow me to mount some turrets on the bottom, which I can't do right now because I tried it once and it got smashed as soon as I landed. So, of course that would kind of screw up and ruin the little vehicle I have here, but honestly I can just run a conveyor down through whatever blocks and then still have the car on the outside. Or I can park it in the bay. You know, if I have it set up right, I can park it inside. And what I can do is I can expand this floor, drop this floor down two blocks, and then have double bay doors so I can park, you know, my big ships in there. So I don't have to worry about the constraint, you know, because I'm kind of hating it that I can't park this guy in here because of the turret. And otherwise, he'd fit perfectly. And, well, it's, you know, it does provide a little tiny bit of the fence. I'd rather just have it inside the bay. Especially if I can't fly it. Like, say I'm in an environment where, like this, where I can't fly it. Like, it's stuck here. I can't move it until I leave this moon and get into an atmosphere. Even with the hydrogen engines, it's not enough because it's so heavily armored. It won't lift off or move, so it's stuck there. And then really, I'd rather have that inside if it's stuck there. So I think I might just do that. I might just raise the ship, you know, 2 or 3 blocks higher, and then build a second floor, put some airlock doors or something in. I'm not really sure how that would work. I guess I could just put airlock doors in vertically so that it would keep it pressurized. I don't know. Or I can just, maybe I can just set it up so the whole thing would be pressurized. I'm thinking about doing it right now because that will allow me to, because I'm thinking I'm really tired. I've been doing this since, you know, the last couple of weeks I've been playing this game. I have to run like this, okay? For every single piece of stuff that I need, I have to run to this cargo container, take it to my 4,000 liter capacity. Then I have to run, you know, say I was building a battery. And then I have to run all the way, like fly this way, fly all the way around, fly down here. You know, then I was running over here to the battery. Well, they use up the parts. You know, I had to make 4 trips to make that battery. So, you know, doing this. That's why I don't film it, because it's tedious. It's tedious and annoying, you know. The truck was built for a mobile refinery. So if I'm actually out over, you know, running around on the craters, which I was earlier, and then the refinery and everything came in handy because I was able to do a couple, you know, I was able to add some thrusters to this guy. I added like a half dozen thrusters just so it would be able to fly in this environment. And that was great because I had everything I needed right here. This is like a completely self-sufficient system. But it's very limited because I can't add any production or efficiency modules to it. I can't expand it in any way. The truck is done. I can't do anything else with it. It's maxed out. This base, however, has a lot of room for expansion, as long as I have the materials. And I'm thinking, what the hell, maybe I should just expand, make this thing a lot bigger and add assembly and refinery with efficiency modules. And then that way, when I use the welding system, or if I make the cruise missile platform, I can have it automatically, I can just dump my ore in this ship and have it automatically generate, you know, the components and everything that I need. So it's kind of like a no-brainer at this point to move on and keep the truck for what it is, but not use it as my primary refinery and assembly, because it's just, for one, it's slow. Like, I'm waiting right now. That's why I'm filming. I'm waiting for it to produce some more stuff for me so that I can continue building. And I can't make it go any faster, and I can't add other refineries. So if I expand the bottom here, say 3 blocks, I could fit all kinds of stuff in here. I could fit, you know, both a refinery and an assembler with several expansions. Like, all this area over here is unused underneath here. And of course, I'm going to go ahead and weld these now that I have the iron. I'm going to go ahead and finish those blocks out. And look, I have all the conveyor system already in place. All I have to do is just cut where I need to add junctions. And of course, I can move the landing gear. That's easy. It takes like 5 minutes to move one of these landing gear. It doesn't take a lot of materials. And, you know, of course, get rid of these spotlights, put them on the new outside or the new bottom. And I can probably have to kill some of these interior lights because they're in the way. But for the most part, I think it'd be a great idea to build underneath this thing. So, of course, I'm going to have to leave this whole front section alone. I can't build anything under it because of the thrusters. So I'd probably, you know, build the wall ending at this conveyor. You know, build it straight back that way, and then build it this way. You know, nothing can pop out where these solar panels are, so I'd have to just make the hard wall right here. But that gave me a lot of room to play with. Then I can take some of these armor blocks out, because I just did that to protect the gravity generator. Maybe I can even move some of this stuff around, because I tried to strategically place it so that if gunfire came in, right, if they were aiming for the gyros, they would hit the conveyor, or they'd hit the landing gear, or they'd hit, you know, something that was not important. And I replaced this engine that way, too. I was like, oh, you know, it's kind of safe from four directions under here, because it's being blocked, right? But I'm going off the space that I can't use. It's like, well, if I just make this ship higher off the ground, that solved several problems. And since I don't need to hook up anymore with this, I can just kind of take this out completely. I don't even need this connector anymore. And that frees up, maybe I can add a second hydrogen tank. In fact, that'd be a pretty awesome idea. Just put a second hydrogen tank under it. Oh, that thing's huge. I think that would take three blocks on its own. But maybe I'll raise this thing four blocks and just make it four tall. It's only a couple, maybe 50 extra blocks I need to make. It's going to be a lot of metal. I'm going to have to probably go get some more iron. But what the hell? I think I might just do that and make that my first project. Then worry about the other stuff later. So anyway, that's my thoughts on that. Hey, check this out. Okay, so here's what I planned on doing. I'm going to make this three more deep. So the landing gear on the corner is going to have one block, basically like that. And then I'll create, you know, a three-block-high wall all the way across on all four. The landing gear is just going to be on the corners, so it doesn't take up any interior space, but there will be one block beneath it, as you can see, to grab onto the surface in case there's some uneven. I didn't want them to be perfectly even with the bottom of the ship, so that'll give me three more high, but if I'm busting out this floor, it actually gives me four more high. But that'll allow me to do the double doors like I wanted to do. And check this out, I put this ramp here so I can take the truck down. What I'm gonna do, and this is, I thought this was great, I'm just gonna bust the floor out of this section here that I didn't fill in, which I'm glad I didn't waste the materials. And then I'm going to, you know, the floor is gonna be, like I said, it'll be like this high. So it's only gonna be two blocks off the ground. Well, I can simply just use these ramps. I can put two ramps. Generally, let's see, it'd be something like, you know, this, and then another one above it, and it would actually allow me to drive the truck without using any kind of rotor. Although I still might rotor this just to pick it up, so it's kind of like, not touching the ground so that when I land it doesn't smack and break. But I'm thinking, okay, that's super cool, and I think I can do the double doors for the truck too, so I'd basically have a huge ship bay that'll allow me to fit really tall big ships, and then I'll have this huge bay over here that I can drive the truck in and out of. And the ramp won't be this huge awkward thing, it'll only be at most this long, like these two ramps long. That would be it, and that would easily fold up along the side and then not look all crazy stupid. In fact, it'd provide a few bullets of protection against the blast doors. All I have to do is rip out this conveyor, which is no big deal. That takes like a minute, and then of course the light. I'm going to deal with this little car later. It has jets, so I can just fly it. I don't need to worry about it smashing into the ground when I let it go. I can actually fly it, put it where I need to put it. I've already gotten rid of the conveyor down here. I was going to see how a second hydrogen tank would be, and it's too big. It would actually wind up hitting the ground, so I'll have to reconsider that. But I'm going, okay, you know what, I think I can actually pull this off where I can pressurize this whole thing. You know, I'll just take this conveyor out and move the car, put it somewhere else to unload. But I should be able to pressurize this hole underneath. Maybe even in the bay where the truck is. would be pressurized too. And it's going to be great to get rid of this friggin' ramp, you know. But the fun part right now is going to be to get the truck down, because I kind of forgot to take the truck off before I raised the platform. I don't want to undo the work, so I just lengthened the ramp so that the angle won't be too brutal. So I'm going to unlock this beast and move it down on the ground, and I'm going to rip this ramp apart, tear the floor out, and start building my walls and my airlocks. So this should be fun. Quick interim update. You can see that I got double doors in. I will actually move the top row down a notch so that they... I decided I'm going to just tear this entire floor out, which means I'm probably going to have to move the jump drive. I can sort of leave it there, I guess, and then just put stuff underneath it. I'm thinking about adding... I'm going to have to tear all this out and then, you know, rebuild it. There's the programming for the rotor, the gravity gen, a bunch of other stuff. I'll just tear that out and I'll put it in more appropriate areas. Now, the jump drive's just in a weird place in the room. However, it's in a good place, you know, distance-wise from the front doors, because when I tear the floor out, I can park... Basically, I have it figured out that the biggest ship I'm going to ever make to put in here is only going to come up to where the jump drive is anyway, so it'll be this long at most. This is actually going to be... This is almost big enough for me to build a large ship in. But, I don't know. I've never really tried to build a small, large ship. Like, this is considered a small, large ship to most people. So, I don't know. That's going to be... Maybe I'll try it. I don't know. I really didn't plan on making large ships that were... for like mining and stuff, and for just flying around and checking areas out. I mean, that's the basically what small ships are for. But I don't know. Maybe I'll give it a shot. If this hole's big enough for me to fly through, I guess we'll find out. So you can see I've got the outline of the new garage. Now, I haven't decided yet if I'm going to pressurize this or not. Part of me says don't waste the time, because I'm going to have to use crazy amounts of hangar doors for this to work. And I'm not even sure how I would do that. I mean, I probably have to bust a couple blocks out here and have a couple going this way, bust a few out here and have them going that way, and then have coming down and going up. I mean, it took a lot of resources just to put six more in. So I don't know. I might just leave it unpressurized and open like this. And maybe put some sides on it. The thing is kind of nice is having it open is it allows the truck to use its weapons to help defend the ship. And also, especially if I leave the top open, it'll allow me to land ships and stuff up there. So, I don't know, I might just leave it open. There's really no reason to close it off, I'm sitting there thinking. It'd just be lots of resources to do it. So, maybe I'll just solidify the floor, you know, put the corners, you know. Obviously, I want to leave some structural integrity in here. I don't want to just have, like, just the floor that could be taken out with one hit, and then my truck goes falling. Yeah, at least if you have a cage structure like this, one side gets taken out, you don't have to worry about the whole thing collapsing. All it takes is one block to keep everything stable. Maybe I'll do that, and then I'll put the... I was thinking about making this a walkway, like the pressurized door here, then putting one on this other side, so I can walk straight through to the outside, both directions. You know, come over here and get into the truck. Putting some extra storage in here. I moved the engine to the bottom. I don't know if I'm going to move the air generator or not. It kind of makes sense to have it on the outside of the ship, so I'm probably going to move it. Probably going to reposition these gyros. If I blow the floor out, I'm going to have to move this stuff. So, it's really not a big deal. Just have to make sure I keep a path for the conveyors. I've been putting extra conveyors in because, like, here's another one. I just haven't finished it because you can never have enough conveyors, especially when you're running hydrogen power and you have all these cargo containers and weapons and turrets and stuff that need to be fed. So it'll be nice to have some skylights, and I'll put a couple extra more, you know, up the top there. So it's coming along. This is where I'm at so far. Okay, quick update here. I've been working on this for quite a while. You can see the progress here. I haven't really done much of anything with the outside over here, except I ran... this thing is armed to the teeth. I have a turret on every single side. Top, bottom, left, right, front, back. And I have two missile turrets, one up front, one up top. So I don't have missile coverage in the back, although that may change. But the big thing I'm about to do, and I think I have this room sealed. I'm about to do a pressure test and see if I sealed all the holes and made all the windows and did everything I was supposed to do. Yeah, check that out. I think I have this done. This is what I was just finished working on, trying to get the ores on one screen, ingots on another, and components on another. And then I have a screen dedicated just to damage, so I know when that's blank, I have no worries. And then this down here, I customized it. It was tricky getting all that stuff on one screen, but I got it all on one screen. It gives me a full rundown of what's going on here, because I got a lot of stuff going on. I have a bunch of extra batteries. I put the gravity generator in the exact center. So I'm now, you know, I don't have a bunch of gravity happening out in the middle of nowhere. Put my gyros back up there. I put in a second nuclear reactor so that I have 30 megawatts now. Check this out. I've never done this before. I never used these modules because they didn't exist when I played Space Engineers 2 years ago. That at the very top, now I figured this all out, so I knew everything was just going to fit, because I wanted to have extra room. There's still some expansion space available for other stuff, but I have an assembler up top, and then I have four of these effectiveness modules, which basically, a refinery up top, that's what I meant to say, refinery up top, and four of these effectiveness modules, which basically doubles the ingots I get from ore. So that means I only have to mine half as much. That is awesome. Over here, I have the assembler, which you can't see because it's kind of up there. There's actually two assemblers. I have two assemblers in co-op mode, and each of them have two productivity modules, so they are twice as fast, both of them. So I'll be able to seriously crank out stuff here. And that's why I have these dedicated screens, so I know what's working, being worked on, how much stuff I have. You can see I really don't have anything. I have no ingots, no components. What I have, what little I have, is in the truck. I used up a lot to do all this stuff so far, but I'm getting there. I have two double airlock systems, so these are the only ways in and out without depressurizing the whole room, but that's fine because, you know, I don't need to have it pressurized all the time. I, you know, still kept the windows up top. I haven't even closed these doors yet, so I'm hoping that when they meet in the middle, that's considered an airtight seal. I put in lots of windows, so it's not so claustrophobic in here. I have a door going down and a door going up. And I put everything in straight lines so I can run from one side to the other. And I still, like I said, I still got to finish this. This won't take very long. It's basically just finishing those blocks and the floor and then building the ramp, which I'll probably put a rotor on. But yeah, this was a little bit of a bitch setting all this up, getting the conveyors to not be super ugly. And that's why I decided to run that tube up top for the turret instead of trying to run across the floor, because, you know, when you try to run across a tube, you kind of get stuck. So really want to do that. Here's that ice making module. So I got that there. There's that turret I told you about. I got the solar panels back up and running. I broke them, of course, whenever I was doing my remodeling. Didn't really change much up front, except I did do this. Probably noticed this right here. My new control center. I can control and fly the ship from inside now, so that is great. Now, let me put the HUD back on. You can see I actually installed some cameras, so I can still see outside without being in that third-person view. So I got some front and back. I mean, I got two front cameras, one back, and then, actually, I didn't switch over. One down, and one in the back. So that is awesome. I'll be able to completely fly the ship from inside. Don't have to worry about getting killed. They get me in here, the destruction is going to be so bad that I'll wind up doing a save game anyway. So, but I'm going to hope that this thing is a beast. And I know this is all light armor. It's not going to hold up very well to gunfire explosions. So, you know, I think when I get enough, if I get lots and lots of iron to the point where I can make thousands of grid, then I can replace some of the more vulnerable sections with heavy armor. But it's so expensive. It actually takes quite a while too, to even, you know, with my elite stuff, my elite tools, it still takes a while to bang that all out. So here, let me start with light armor, see how it holds up. My weapons are good enough, they won't get close, right? So, I guess we'll see how that works. Okay, my whole point of this recording was I wanted to show you, I have not tested the room yet, so this is going to be my first time. I programmed, since I have so many friggin' doors, I didn't want to run around and close them all, so I just programmed the button to do it. I don't know which one's open and which one's closed. Okay, so that must be open. There we go. Every door closed. That's awesome. And this here is the hangar door. And let's see, as soon as that closes, if I did everything right, this air filter should turn green. Okay, I didn't do everything right. It still says there's a leak somewhere. The thing is, I'm pretty sure I sealed everything. I didn't. Well, I obviously didn't, because the room is not airtight. I did finish all the windows, I think. Yeah. That door's closed. That one's closed. Okay, well, I guess, I was hoping for some excitement, air pressure here, but that ain't happening. I'm pretty sure that, yeah, it says room not pressurized. Now, I hope that that module is considered pressurized, and that the spotlight would be considered pressurized, although I can probably test that. Alright, well, I'm gonna figure out where I'm leaking. Like, I might be leaking around the spotlights. Or watch, it doesn't support two doors coming together. Now, that would just ruin it. Then I just wouldn't pressurize. I mean, it's not the end of the world. Okay, well, that's the update. I'm gonna go ahead and finish this thing up, and then it's gonna be time me to go to bed, and then tomorrow I think I'm gonna start working on my kick-ass fighter ship so I can explore this moon and get my truck back up on this platform. And man, this is like so much better. This is like a real ship now. It doesn't, you know, doesn't feel like it was hacked together. It actually feels like I put thought and effort into it, which, you know, I did. Kind of got this figured out. I still got some room. still got a little bit of room to play with, so that's kind of cool. I can't wait to take on a few pirates in this thing and see how it holds up. Okay, until then. Here we go. Bada bing. Let's test this. It still blows a little bit of air out, but it doesn't kill it. And you can actually leave the outside door open until you come back in. The thing is, I wish it would... I still hate the way that's done. Cursor just doesn't work like it should. That's pretty cool. You can essentially just leave the indoor or outdoor open, depending on where you're at. Let me show you what it was. See, I just blew the air out of the whole place because I wasn't even pointing at the door. You saw what I did, right? I pointed this way. So I did it again. Ugh, just so annoying. They gotta fix these bugs. Figure 3 years in development, they'd have all this stuff nailed. It was these, this new mod, these, moisture vaporators that take moisture out of the air and convert it into ice. Well, I had them over here at the corner, and I found out that even though this block on the corner looks like it's airtight, this module's not considered airtight. This unit is not airtight, and neither is the module. So it's pretty obvious the modules aren't airtight because they're not even, you know, obviously they have huge gaps around the sides and stuff. But you know, you kind of think the bottom of these would be airtight, but no, it doesn't work that way. It's either airtight or not for the whole thing. So this actually worked out better because I'm able to use two now. I only had room to fit one, and in order to use the entire productivity module, you need to use two of these because it's only got one input. Can't. Basically, I was losing half of this module. I wasn't able to use it, but now since I got two, I'm able to use the productivity module. So each one of these is working at 100-150%. And what's even cooler is if I really wanted to go crazy, I could keep adding these all the way across because I have all the space up here. And I'm not putting the roof on. I'm just going to basically finish these blocks all the way around. I mean, you can see how fast the Elite tool works, and the problem is, of course, that I'm going to run out of steel really fast. So I finish that, get the flooring, get the ramp done, and I am ready to rock. So there it is, airtight hangar, and all the goodies. When I have everything done and tweaked, we'll do a full tour. For you, I finally finished the Mothership. So I will go ahead and take you on a tour. Okay, first of all, I have the two fighters parked up top. Both of them are completely useless in this environment. I have not built the replacement for this one yet, but that's next on my list. We'll start with the outside. I added lots of lights. It looked really cool at night. I was kind of waiting for the sun to come up before I did this video because it's hard to see anything at night, especially when you don't have an atmosphere. But I added spotlights in each direction, interior lights, you know, it'll kind of light everything up a bit. You can see I got the truck in here. And not only that, but that stupid landing gear thing that I had on the front broke off twice going up and down the ramp. So I said, you know what, there has to be a better way. So I says, you know what, let's use the existing connector on top, and boom, you know? I can actually, if I put the pistons up, it's just close enough to make the connection. So now, the station can power the truck, so I can shut the batteries and reactors off in this thing, which is what I did. Plus, it can use the resources of the assembler and refinery in co-op mode, so the factories inside can work with the factories here, and, you know, we got, like, three factories going on, so that, you know, that's awesome. That was the only modification I made to the truck, and I was glad, because I really hated that landing gear thing on the front. It always kept smacking into things. You see, I have turrets in every direction now. I have, Gatling turrets on every single side, including coverage on the bottom. Although I don't have one on the bottom, the ones that I do have will cover if bad guys come up from the bottom of the ship when I'm in space. So I got the solar panels rocking. I got those pre-programmed, so they're working again. No changes to the welding. There's the extra rocket launcher that I have. And I was able to pretty easily get the car under here and get it connected to the connector. I just took a little hopping, but I got it connected. So that is up and out of the way, tires lifted up, so that's plenty of room for me to land without crushing it, hopefully. I haven't broke it yet. I still left the cockpit outside, sort of like a backup. One thing I have yet to do before I take off is program the hotkeys. So I have all these hotkeys in here, like three rows of them, that I need to transfer to the inside. I wish there was an easy way to do that, but now you have to do them manually. Okay, so I will show you the cool ramp, which is much smaller than the other one because we're closer to the ground, and it took me a while to try to figure out how to do this, but I got it working. So you gotta put the piston out first. Then you put the ramp down. While we're waiting for that, I'll go ahead and open the big doors here. I mean, look at that. That just looks awesome. So you see how I did that with the ramps upside down. Now, I don't have no idea why it's not touching the ground. It was before. It's a little strange. Anyway, then you bring the piston back in. And that kind of closes the gap. And that's as close as I can get it. Now, let me tell you, it's definitely a challenge getting the small wheels over this. Because the big wheels, of course, have no problem. But then the small wheels get caught in here. It requires a lot of thrust. And in this 0.25G environment, I don't have any problem getting up and down it with a little bit of effort. Now, when this is a 1G environment, I don't know if this is going to work. I did put like little lip ramps up here, and all that did was break everything. So this worked. I ran up and down this ramp 4 times, and it works. So, and then to put it back up, it's the reverse. You have to put the piston out first, because if you don't, it'll just bash in everything when it turns. When the piston turn or the rotor turns up, it'll smash in everything and break everything. So you have to do this in order. Yeah, I could do timer blocks and programmable blocks and everything else. I really didn't want to add more complexity to it. I put the ramp up and down maybe once per planet, so it's not a big deal to just push the buttons. I'm sure I can speed this up, but you know what? I kind of like the realism. That's about how fast it would move in real life. You don't really need to crank everything up. So once that's up, you can bring the piston back in. And it tucks it in really nice. To the point where it's actually kind of protective in the back. Now, of course, that means the turret in the back can't really do anything except shoot out the side, but we still have this side turret, which is functional, the top turrets, which are functional, and the front rocket launcher, which is still functional in a couple different directions. Now, hopefully, and I won't know this until we're in battle, that these weapons don't destroy the ship, because they sometimes don't account for line of sight. Like, they'll think that there's a ship behind this block and just try to shoot through it. Now, if that happens with those missiles, it's just going to destroy the whole ship. So we're not going to know until it's wartime. And if something like that happens, I'll come back to the save and I'll just turn off the turrets on the truck and just say, hey, you know what? I don't really need them anyway. There's probably plenty of defense here between, you know, all the... I have two rocket launchers and I think six turrets, and then I have this one, and I'll probably have another ship up here with a rocket launcher on it so pretty soon. So that's that. So there's the ramp. Much better than before. So inside, I already showed you guys all the airlock doors. And the pressurization, which, you know, that's all controlled from this panel. I have also the gravity generator. Boom, 0.65G. So it's all switch activated. If I want gravity, I can kick it on. You know, for the most part, I leave it off because I don't like to use more hydrogen than I have to fly around. I added a second air vent because that one, it took like 30 seconds to fill the room, so now it's like 15 seconds. It's definitely faster. So I got my battery bank. I left room for three more batteries because I'm probably going to need them if I add the automated mining stuff, automated mining driller, which I did not add to this ship, but I was considering it. I'll worry about that later. I have my whole factory assembler and refinery with all the upgrades. They're cranking, ready to go. I got my second reactor, I think I mentioned that before. My gyros are up there with my programmable box and my timer, so all that stuff is tucked away up there. What a weird laggy frame rates. I think I showed you guys the panels. I got them tweaked out for the values that I want, you know, so I actually have it set so... actually, I thought I set the components. I thought I set the metal grid a lot higher than 500. Anyway, I'll go back to visit this. There was, basically, I changed these numbers so that this bar reflects how many I really want to have. Like, I do want to have a lot more than... Oh, I have 5,000 steel plate. Okay, I was looking at the wrong thing, metal grid. Yeah, so I do have a 5K steel plate, which you can see right now, I am almost out of steel plate. In fact, I think I am out of steel plate. It shows zero. And I believe, I'll have to double check, I probably don't have, I probably have it set up just to show what's on the station and not what is in the truck. Now, I might want to change these panels to reflect what is also in the truck. I think I have it set up just to map the cargo containers on this ship. And that's the same thing I did with this. I set this all up today so that it's only showing the reactors, the batteries, and the power for this ship, not anything else that's connected, because every time I connect up something, it throws these numbers way off. So I really don't know what the ship is doing because it has all this other stuff attached to it, and all those batteries and all those reactors get added in, and I really don't want those things getting drained and then, you know, finding myself without uranium while flying around because it was sucked dry from my station. Those two reactors should be plenty for now. So there's the gravity gen. The jump drive, of course, is all still tucked up in there, and I think that's it. You have my medical bay. I was going to put a cryo chamber until I realized in single player it's kind of pointless, so I did not add one. What is nice about the medical room is when you do have it conveyored, it fills your hydrogen and oxygen too. That I did not know until I hooked it up to a conveyor and I said, whoa, check it out, I got my full recharge. So that's excellent. Like I said, here I still gotta set up my hotkeys before I fly, because without my hotkeys, obviously I'm dead in the water. But there's the new ship, and look how smooth and sleek it is underneath. I mean, I have nothing going on down here. I'm, you know, the only thing I have is you know, an engine and a spotlight, and that's it. Oh, and my door down here. So it's very clean. And now it's not completely helpless, and you know, pretty much from every direction I have enough armor, I think, to survive an attack. So the only way we're gonna know is when it happens. And I've been safe here. For some reason the script is not spawning ships to come after me here. Only if I go about 10-15 kilometers will ships just start appearing and swarm me like in my last video. So that is going to wrap up this video. This is going to be all about the station and how I built it and the final product. So next video is going to be probably me flying around this moon and figuring out what the hell those pirates are protecting. If there's a base here, or if there's any abandoned ships or any other kind of loot I could score. So, until then.